feature of this system is very interesting for the users and the students, that it allows the students to assemble the circuit with their own hands and to get the very visualized and practical value of the experimental circuits, and it will give the great educative and learning value from the practical and concepts of electronics design. The students can make circuit with their own hands, they can get the easy and much great experience of the practical value with this kit. So now we move on to description of this kit, with the what are the components we are providing with this and what are the accessories we are providing with this kit. This is the trainer kit, which is the analog overlay learning system. The order code for this trainer kit is 33529. We are also providing a user manual, and this is the more than a user manual because it consists a lot of information and knowledge about the components which are used in basic electronics in electronics devices. Also, we are providing tracing paper to ease and access of circuit, which give very easy and helpful experience to students to build up the circuits with this kit. Also, patch cords of different sizes and the hookup wires to connect the circuits, and multimeters to take the voltages and ampermeters as required from this analog system. Now we open this kit and I will explain you the different components. There all are the resistors of different values. These are the capacitors of different values. These are the non-polar capacitors over here, and these are the polar capacitor or electrolyte capacitors which will be used in circuits. These are the semiconductor circuits, which is diodes here, and these are the LEDs, light emitting diodes, and these are the transistors of different values, and these are the ICs. This is the IC section. So move on to the other section. This is the breadboard, which is the important component of this kit, because all of the circuit are made on this breadboard. These are the potentiometers of different values. These are the toggle switches. This is the input speaker, which is impedance of 8 ohm. These are the transformers, which gives the AC supply, because it is an analog training board. We need AC supply also. And this is the twicer, which I use to pick the small components while making the circuits. So now we move on to the experiments from making the circuits with this kit and the components provided with this kit. On to our first experiment. With this experiment we need a breadboard. So to understand how a breadboard works, how the configuration of breadboard and how to use breadboard with the making of this circuit, and how we use trace paper to tracing the circuit with this breadboard, you can refer our video of order kit 33528, which is the digital overlay learning system which will be provided to the YouTube channel of Tesca. Now we move on to the circuit. For this, our circuit is light emitting diode in DC circuits. For this, we provide positive supply to the distribution strip here and the negative supply adjacent to down strip of distribution terminal strip. Now we need a resistance of 470 ohm. This is the 470 ohm resistance. Take it out. And put this to the positive terminal of power supply and place it to the any terminal of half strip. Now we will use an LED, sorry, we will take a diode place the anode terminal of diode in series with the resistance and cathode terminal to any of the blank half strip. Now take an LED put the cathode of anode of LED to any point of half terminal strip and the cathode of LED to the ground. Now we will use a multimeter. The positive knob of the multimeter will be connected to the cathode of diode and negative lead of this multimeter will be connected to the anode of this LED. Now set the multimeter to the DC current approx 20 milliampere or 30 milliampere. Now always verify the circuit before switch on the power. So now for understanding the circuit and how it works, we first power on the supply. Right now supply is at 0 volt. We gradually increase the supply and note down the values in this table provided in manual. Applied voltage is right now 0. We apply the voltage around 1 volt. This is around 1 volt. You can also note down the current from this multimeter. Now we increase the voltage to 5 volts. This is approximately 5 volts. At this time you will see LED starts glowing because the 5 volts are enough to glow an LED. And you can also see the currents in milliamperes in the multimeter. Now again increase the voltage to 10 volts. At this time you can also see the current is increased in this LED and LED is much brighter than it is on 5 volts. So that's how you will understand the circuit of LED in the DC circuit with this analog overlay learning system. Now we move on to our next experiment. Now we will going our do our second experiment, which is an oscillator circuit, the phase shift oscillator. For this the circuit is given in this user manual. We will build up this circuit on this breadboard. For this we need to connect the power supply, the positive of power supply terminal to this distribution strip and the negative of the power supply terminal to the lower distribution strip. Now we will first use a transistor. This is 2N double two transistor. This is the emitter, base and collector of this transistor. So we install this transistor in the breadboard. Properly place the pins in the breadboard. Now we will use the capacitor of 0.01 microfarad. Connect it the half terminal strip on anywhere. So we will start from there. Take a 4K7 resistance This is the 4K7 resistance. Place the one end of this resistance to positive and the other end in line with the collector circuit. So there are 5 short terminals from different ways in the circuit. So connect the resistance on the first point of this terminal, half strip terminal, they are vertically connected. Now take a 68k resistance. Let me find out the 68k resistance. So this is the 68k resistance. Place the one terminal of this resistance in line with collector half strip and other terminal to any blank half strip. Take a hookup wire, pin this hookup wire in the collector circuit and connect this to the capacitor that we have installed earlier. Now again connect an 0.01 microfarad capacitor on the half strip of the last capacitor we have added and place it to any blank terminal. Properly place the components so that you will not get any loose connections. Now we will use a potentiometer. We can use this template of port installation, and also you can install any type of and any sizes of potentiometer on this plate. This is the 4K7 potentiometer we are using here, which is described in the circuit. Connect one terminal of potentiometer to the capacitor and other terminal of the potentiometer to any blank strip. Also the output need to be shorted. Now we take a 4K7 resistance again. Connect this resistance to this both the connected capacitors terminal and other terminal to the ground. Now again we need a 470 ohm resistance. This is here. Connect this resistance to the negative terminal of port and the other terminal to the ground. And now take an 0.01 microfarad capacitor, which needs to be connect one terminal to the 68k ohm resistance. Other terminal to the output of the potentiometer. Now take a hookup wire, connect the both shorted point of capacitor and 68k resistance to the base of the transistor. Now take an hookup wire from the emitter terminal . Place this open and the collector terminal and the other wire to the emitter terminal. Now at this both point we will observe our oscillator waveform with the help of CRO. So now we again verify our circuit. Always verify the circuits. Also we need to connect the emitter circuit, emitter terminal to ground, that we have forgot to connect it. That's why I always say verify your circuit before switching on the power supply. We have verified our circuit that all components are connected properly, all the connections are doing, all the connections are connected right way as the circuit diagram. Now we will observe the waveform at the SCRO. For this, first we will power on the supply. We need here plus 9 volt supply in the circuit. This is a traditional circuit. For safety purpose we set this to the 9 volts. We can also observe the supply in the 10 volt circuit also, but according to traditional circuit diagram we will set this value to the 9 volt. Now connect the CRO's positive probe to the collector terminal and negative to the negative terminal. Here you can see at the CRO, this is the oscillator waveforms. As I varies the port, the frequency of this oscillator also varies. This goes to maximum to minimum, then again. You can also see the frequency here. That is 4 kilohertz, and as I vary the oscillator wave, the frequency goes lower and lower. So that's how our circuit is working. And you can do many and many, there are a lot of experiments provided in this manual, and also given the tracing diagrams for doing the ease of access of experimenting. All the experiments are given with the tracing diagrams, so you will find no difficulty to design any experiments. And that's it for today. For any queries and any questions, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.